So when the study came out and said the fasting group lost more lean muscle mass, yeah, they did, because that's the point of fasting. But what they didn't say, what the news headline didn't say, was that what you break your fast with matters. So on the other side of autophagy is something called mTOR. Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, we are diving into a new study that showed when you fast, you lose muscle. I definitely have a strong opinion about this one. So I am going to share what the study said, and then I'm going to show you what my thoughts are and how you can fast so you don't lose muscle. That's on this video. And those of you that are new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. I am a woman on a mission to get a million people fasting. So hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and I will bring you everything I know about fasting, and you'll find a ton of videos here as well. And those of you been on this journey with me, sharing this stuff out, I just love you. I love your comments, and I love being on this journey with you. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. This has just been an incredible experience to watch you get healthy through these videos. Okay, I got a lot of messages on this study a few weeks ago, and it was a study that came out. It was a human study, and it was published June 2021, and it showed that when people fast, it was a person study, human study, that they broke muscle down. And how it was broader was profiled on social media a lot was that, well, maybe we shouldn't fast then if we don't want to lose muscle. That's not the case. So I am going to break this study down for you. First, it was a 24-hour study, so alternate day fasting study. So that's the first thing that I want you to know. They had people eat whatever they want one day and then fast the next, eat what they want and then fast. That's a form of intermittent fasting. It's called alternate day fasting. So what they found was, here were the four findings, that the people who fasted, they did two groups of people. They fed them the same food, but one did this alternate day fasting and one, they just let them eat all day long. So the group that fasted, what they found is they lost more lean muscle mass. Just put that little thought in the back of your head for a moment, because I'm going to bring this to the surface. Second, the fasting group had less fat loss. That's not what other studies say. I'm going to show you here in a moment. They also said that the fasting group had no significant changes in insulin sensitivity. That's also interesting. That's not what other studies say. That's not what you guys are finding. How many of you have overcome pre-diabetes and have lowered down your insulin medications? And I mean, the stories are amazing. Put it in the comments if that's you. And then the fourth one, which was really interesting, and I want to get into the nuance of this one, is that fasting didn't result in any changes in gene expression for inflammation or autophagy. Interesting, because that's not what other studies are showing. So let's break this down. Are you ready? Okay, first, the science is never settled. So when we see people say that, when people say the science is settled, that's such a stupid statement, because the purpose of science is to constantly prove itself wrong. You come out with a study and you go, this was our hypothesis, this is what we think is gonna happen. And then you study it and you're like, ah, that either did happen or didn't happen. And then the way that researchers work is they look at that study and then they, maybe a couple of years down the road, they try to decide if they need to disprove that. Science is always evolving. It's always disproving itself. New hypotheses are coming up all the time. So when we look at one individual study, we want to glimmer little pieces from it, but we don't go, okay, that's it. My muscle's going to be lost when I fast. End of the game, I'm done fasting. That's not what we do, because science is never settled. Okay, other things that I want you to know on this is that as you fast longer, more and more healing switches get turned on. So I'm gonna leave a link in the notes for an incredible study. I've done videos on this that was put in Cell Metabolism 2019, only a couple of years behind this study, that showed when a person for 4 weeks did 36 hours of fasting and then had an eating window of 12 hours and then 36 hours of fasting and then 12 hours that they decreased belly fat and that the inflammation biomarkers went down. So they lowered inflammation and they burned more belly fat. So here's a study that is contradicting what this study is saying when it says losing muscle mass. So the first thing I want you to know is this is how we look at studies. We don't fall prey to headlines. We don't fall prey to, you know, clickbait scenarios that people might be putting out there. Okay, second thing, when you are fasting, your body is going into a state of autophagy. And in autophagy, there is a breakdown, there is a detox. That's the purpose of fasting. Fasting goes after stored sugar, and stored sugar is in your liver, it is in your muscles, and so it's in your fat. So your body wants to break that down to be able to get to the stored sugar and release it so it doesn't stay in there and make you insulin resistant and make you gain weight. That's the purpose of fasting. And it also stimulates autophagy where the cells become so efficient and they repair themselves. That's the point of fasting. So when the study came out and said the fasting group lost more lean muscle mass, yeah, they did, because that's the point of fasting. But what they didn't say, what the news headline didn't say, was that what you break your fast with matters. So on the other side of autophagy is something called mTOR. And mTOR is where we build up a cell and we make it stronger, specifically muscle. So when we go into these longer fasts, you go into a 24-hour fast, you go into a 36-hour fast, you are breaking down. And then when we break that fast with something like protein, we are building muscle back up. And it is this in and out of fasting and breaking the fast that is going to give you this incredible lean, strong muscle that so many people are looking for. So it's the breaking of the fast that dramatically matters. So if you want more muscle, go into the longer fasts and then break it with protein. It's that simple. Okay, last couple of thoughts. Remember that varying the lengths of fast is very important. The longer you fast, the more healing goes on in your body. If you want more metabolic flexibility, then you want to learn how to move in and out of these fasts. And the final thing I'm going to tell you is that when you look at studies, when you look at a video like I'm giving you right now, what I want you to do is look at the information and go, fascinating. Oh my God, my body is miraculous. And then I want you to customize it for you. We have to get away from the one size fits all healthcare system. It is not working. So when we look at a study like this, we've got to individualize it for ourselves. So if you love this information, the next video I would send you to is called Can You Work Out When You Fast? That's a question you guys ask me a lot. And if you want to know how I like to work out to build muscle, especially as a 51-year-old woman, come and join my academy every Saturday, or most Saturday mornings. I do a workout with my academy members. It's a really cool experience. We work out together. I lead it. Sometimes my health coach Paige will lead it. Most times I lead it. And then we do a little coffee talk and I share new science that I've seen and new conversations that I have. It's just a cool experience. And if you're in my academy, you can join us for that experience. So just put Reset Academy in the comments and my team will send you the link. And as always, if you have a great story specifically about building muscle, put it in the comments so we can all learn from your experience, but never give up on yourself and never fall prey to these headlines that want to suck you in and take you back to your old lifestyle. You are more powerful than that. Hope that helps.